As a TF2 player, have you been on a casual mode server in the past 3 years and experienced unplayable lag from the server's end, with other players noting the same thing? No? Yeah, me neither. This, my friends, is thanks to a recent-ish implementation of Steam Datagram Relay in Team Fortress 2, and I'm here today to explain exactly what this means and how it benefits both you and game servers. Steam Datagram Relay, or SDR, essentially acts as a VPN to carry game traffic across Valve's internal network of relays. While VPNs are traditionally known to increase ping, or latency, Valve's relays are structured in such a way that they can reduce these ping times by simply being faster routes than the sent packets would traditionally take. Plus, with Valve's network having lots of capacity, they can handle the extra traffic from DDoS attacks if need be, taking the burden away from individual game servers. Let's start with latency. If I join a game server that doesn't use SDR, like most current community servers, the connection is pretty straightforward. The packets are sent from my computer to my ISP, and then to the game server. Between the connection from my ISP to the game server, there could be suboptimal routing, and additional unnecessary hops to add latency. This example is being extremely simplified. If I join a game server that does use SDR, like casual mode, the packets are sent from my computer, which is connected to Valve's network, to my ISP, and then ultimately to an SDR relay, instead of the server directly. Despite it looking slightly more complicated, it often leads to lower latency, as Valve's network can find a faster internal route to the game server. Again, this is another extremely simplified example. Now let's take a look at the DDoS protection. In the September 16th, 2021 patch for TF2, a new launch option, enablefakeip, was implemented. When you start a server with this new launch option enabled, the console will provide a fake IP address to be used to connect to the server, hiding the server's real IP address in the process. This fake IP address does not appear in the format of a public IP, meaning it isn't nearly as susceptible to DDoS attacks, and this fake IP changes every time the server software restarts. The only real way the server could be DDoS attacked at this point is if its public IP was already known before it started using SDR. One downside of this approach, however, is that a server using SDR cannot be added to a user's favorites or blacklist, as there's no easy way to identify or keep track of it, aside from using a game server login token. But TF2 currently does not consider this for identifying SDR-enabled community servers. While community servers using SDR initially didn't appear on the server browser at all, the 64-bit update on April 18th, 2024, restored this functionality. Now, how can I tell if a server is using SDR? If you start Team Fortress 2 and look in the top right of the Steam overlay, there should be nothing there. That's normal. If you join a server and still see nothing there, the server that you're connected to is not using SDR. However, if you join a server and check the overlay to find a message like this, telling you you're in a game server in a specific area, or like this, telling you you have an active Steam networking connection, then the server is using SDR, and you can rest easy knowing both your IP address and the server's IP address are being masked. If you'd like to enable SDR on your game client to prevent your IP address from leaking when you run a map solo, or to enable it on your server to prevent DDoS attacks, even knowing about the loss of favorites and the IP changing constantly, you can add the launch option enablefakeip to your startup options. As an added bonus, if you're using this as a player and not as a server host, you can use this to test out maps with friends without the need for a dedicated server or port forwarding. I have a video about this on my second channel if you're interested in more details. Anyway, that about wraps it up for this video. Thanks for watching! If you learned something new or this helped you out in some way, feel free to leave a like and/or comment down below. If you want to be the first to know next time I release a video, be sure to subscribe too. I also stream custom TF2 maps on Twitch every Thursday night at 7 p.m. Eastern. Link in description. See you later!